What's up, guys? We are going to go do one of my favorite things, and that is flip bass in bushes. Water's up here on Kentucky and Barkley Lakes, so we are going to get out here, going to put the arc rods to use, and give you a few tips on catching some green ones out of the bushes here on these flooded lakes. Water just came up. It'd been up. They'd been catching some fish in the bushes. They sucked the guts out of these two lakes and brought it down. Water was way out of the bushes. Guys were fishing out, and the water turned around, and we had a lot of rain. They're flooding, and they're bringing the lakes up, holding the lakes so they don't flood the Mississippi River anymore. So good news for us is the water's back in the bushes. So we're going to get out there, get after it, and have a good time at it. So stay tuned. We're going to go out there and catch some.
Well, here we are. We're on Lake Barkley. Water's up. We're 360 versus a normal 359 summer pool, so water's definitely here in the bushes. Has been for about 3 days. We normally get water in the bushes about 358. Not real good. Certain banks will, but once you hit that 359 and a half, 360 mark, pretty much any bush in the lake is going to be on the water or in the water. And there's one there. That one there came out of a little bit of a point bush, but it's on a flat. Nice. That's what we're looking for today. Catch a bunch of those, we'll have a good day. What we're on now is a flat, and then what you've got is your bank bushes. So this is like a spawning flat, real shallow. Normally this doesn't even have water on it in the wintertime. And it takes a while for the water to get up into these bushes. These bank bushes, little steeper banks like that, it doesn't take as much water for the water to get up into those bushes. And a lot of times those are the first bushes those fish will come to. And then in these flats, like behind us back there, there's a creek. Well, the fish will follow these creeks back, and those are the first ones they usually get on is the creek channel ones, because that's the deepest water that they follow down the way back. And then they'll milk into all these other bushes that are out here in this little bit shallower water. And each day you got to come in here and figure out which ones they're on. If they're on point bushes, if they're on the creek bushes, if they're on just bushes that are really full but don't have a real good base to them. Some of these are going to have real good, they'll have good trunks coming out. And those make the best spawning ones. They'll get up against the base of those and make their beds. And that's another key too is, Are you catching fish that are spawning, or are you just catching fish that are coming up with the water and then they're in here cruising and eating and maybe protecting fry from the previous spawn? That'll tell you too where you gotta throw the pitch your bait, whether it's right at the heart of the base of them or if you can get by with flipping around the outskirts of them. But that fish took off my bait, my trailer, so we're gonna get ourselves rigged back up with another trailer. As far as trailers go, when I'm using a jig, I like to have something that's pretty much not going to have a lot of movement, not a lot of appendages, even when I'm flipping plastics. I don't want a lot of appendages. When it goes down through the bush isn't going to give like grass will. So grass you can get by with maybe a bigger craw, or get by with like a lizard or something has other creature baits with a lot of appendages on it. And if that appendage goes over the grass, the grass will give and it'll let it all fall. If you get a lot of appendages here and you're flipping the bushes, that thing will grab and hold your jig or your weight or whatever it is, hang it up in there in the bush. So you want something that's going to go down there through pretty quick. So the Big Bite baits, this is a new one they came out with last year. It is their, I just threw it back in here. The Big Bite Baits Yo Daddy. This is a 3-inch Yo Daddy. It is a perfect size craw. I even flipped this just on as a plastic, but as a craw for a craw trailer. It's got enough action in the legs to put a little vibration out there, but yet they're not wide. If you see that, they're not a real wide. It's not like a regular one where they're out here and they paddle way out and get hung. That falls pretty much straight down. One of my favorite baits to pitch with, especially when it's plastics, is their craw tube. I mean, when that goes down through there, there's nothing. I mean, when it comes to flipping something, a tube is probably one of the best things for grass too, but for in the wood, brush and any of that. It just comes through so slick. There's nothing hanging out of it. It's just got a nice, decent, bulky, and you can get in a tube, you can get a rattle in there too, which I love when it comes to fishing brush. That thing's banging around down in and it can draw a lot of attraction to it. So, but when you, that way when you're doing a trailer, something that's gonna be compact and will go down through it very easy. As far as weights and sizes when it comes to flipping, I generally try to go as light as possible like anything else, but I tend to find myself around that 3/8 to 1/2 is probably what I'll pick up most of the time. Head design for a jig too. I'm flipping the Outcast Tackle Jig Juice today, and it's got kind of a blocky style head there. It bounces through that stuff very well. You don't need that cone head like you would for grass. You want something a little bit wider that's gonna bounce through there and not get hung like in the Ys of the branches and all. So that's a real good one. Got a rattle on there. I don't know if you can hear that or not, but it definitely makes a little bit more noise bouncing down through there. And this is a 1/2 ounce. It's about as heavy as I like to go, because normally when you're flipping bushes, you're not flipping that deep of water. And you're not generally worried about it getting hung up like you do on a mat where you got to flip it up and it's heavy. You know, you got to try to get it down through that mat. Here, it's going to bounce its way down through there. As long as you don't have a trailer that's got, like I was saying, with the appendages hanging it up all the time. Even when I'm flipping the tube or any plastics, I'll try to stay in that 3/8 ounce, not much more than 1/2, just because I don't want the extra size big weight either having to go down through there. Definitely helps get it down and bounce through. And the biggest thing on the way out, one thing I have found, is don't get yourself in a hurry pulling that weight, the jig or whatever lure you got using, down through there. Just reel it up through there somewhat slow, just kind of pull it up, shake it up through, and it'll usually come out of there pretty good. The guys that will have problems is the guys that get in a hurry and they want to jerk it up out of there and get their next pitch in. And what will happen is, I don't care what kind of brush guard you got on there, a weed guard, it's going to wind up pushing it down. You're going to get hung on a limb. You may not stick it with the hook into the limb, but you're going to hook the throat of the hook on a limb. And there you are trying to shake it off, and you're going to go in and mess up maybe a good bush that should have a fish on it. Again, until you get a bunch of bites during the day and can kind of key in on maybe what the fish are doing, if they're in the heart of the bush, if they're out in front of the bush, you just kind of got to flip at everything, and it might take you a while in the beginning to move along, but as soon as you get a few bites and kind of figure out what's going on, what those fish are doing, what they want, then you can kind of go into almost every bay and hit that part of the bush. You know, if you're on a bite where they're not really spawning but they're up cruising, you can just kind of flip around the outside of the bushes where they're just using the bush to kind of hide in, but they'll come out and eat. That's great, because then you're not having to spend your time getting back in and right at the heart of them, where if they're at the very bottom and they're spawning, they're not going to move very far to go get a bait. So you're having to go in and get after them, and you tend to get hung up a lot more just for that fact that you're trying to get it in a whole lot tighter place. And another thing to watch too is live green bushes versus dead bushes. It seems dumb, it seems like it's just wood in the water, but I have definitely noticed on different days that a live bush will way outproduce a dead bush, and other days, you know, just a dead woody bush down there, that's all they're not worried about the cover of the leaves and everything else. That can make a difference. Like flipping grass, you'll get two different types of bites. You get that bite when you pitch it in there, you'll see the whole bush and everything move and pick it. I mean, he just smokes it, and you'll get the bites a lot of times where you pitch it in there and you're only in a couple foot of water at the most, and you won't feel that bite. You just go to pick it up and it's heavy, or you already see your line swimming off with it. So you definitely got to be a line watcher. As far as line goes, 100% fluorocarbon. When it comes to flipping, that or even heavy mono, but I choose fluorocarbon. I run Sunline Shooter. I got 20-pound test line. I'll go up to 25 even. Seems to work very good. do not use braid. It is so sensitive that every time it hits a limb, you're going to want to set the hook. And the other thing is, too, it doesn't give. So when you set the hook on a fish there in the bush and bow up on him, if that line cuts down through that limb at all, or that fish gets you wrapped up, it is not going to give and give you the chance to let him on swing or to get yo-yo him back and forth and maybe get him out of there. I just, over and over and over again, I've seen it where guys, you know, they'll have their braided line on from fishing grass. When I come back from Florida, all my rods got, you know, braid on them from fishing grass, and come up here and they don't take it off, and they just have it's a very hard time flipping with it. You can't snap your baits out of the stuff as well, or if you get kind of hung up, you can't shake it or give it the old bow and arrow trick to get it on hung. It just doesn't work. So get yourself some good quality fluorocarbon, some 20, 25 pound fluorocarbon, and you'll be set. As far as rods go, when flipping bushes, and when I'm flipping grass and stuff, I like a nice long rod, 7-11, 7-10, even an 8-footer. You got lots of room, usually punching mats or something or whatever, and you get that bait way back in there. When it comes to flipping bushes, about a 7-6, 7-3, 7-4, something in that range is what I like. For the reason being, here, we don't have so much cover. It's not as big of a deal. Another nice fish. That's what we're looking for. Outcast juice jig, 1/2 ounce. Big bite baits, yo daddy. Pretty fish. Good quality fish. As I was saying, this one here is an arc sniper. This is a 7.3 mag medium heavy. And as you can see, it's got plenty of snort to pull those fish out of there. The other one I like using is the 7.6 heavy flipping rod. Both of them got great snort, pull them out. And then I'm throwing my, this here's the sniper. This is the 7.6 medium heavy that I've got my plastics on. The reason for the shorter rods is out here it's not as big of a deal, but when you get back in some of these places, you actually got trees that are coming out over the bushes. And if you get those longer rods, even the 7.6 sometimes, you get those longer rods, you go to make that pitch, and the next thing you know, your rod tips up in the tree, and you got your line wrapped up in there, and it's just a mess. And even when you set the hook, you're trying to have to set it off to the side or do whatever. So I find that you know, a 7.2, 7.3, somewhere in there, you can get a heavy enough rod and then keep yourself down a little bit and keep yourself out of the tree. So that's something else. That's fun. Let's do that again. That was like the third flip I've made in that tree too. That one was back in the heart of it. I'm gonna show you that. Take this camera off here. But what I'm talking about in these bushes is right here is a bush that is bushy bush, if you want to call it that. It's pretty spread out and whatnot. You look over here where I just caught that fish, and he was back in there up against all that hard. See that kind of root system back there, the trunk and everything? He was up against that. And that's kind of telling me that fish was probably gonna make a bed back in there. He could have hit anywhere else around any of it. You know, you get in these, you can see back there where they can get around just some of these other ones and hide from bait fish and whatnot. But scan it back. But he was at the heart of that one, and that's telling me, and I had to flip in there a couple times to get that bite. That's kind of telling me he's probably in there trying to get a bed ready, and he's waiting for the misses to come around. Thank you. not a giant. That's why we have strong line. Whew. Can't tell me that's not fun. After that, I think I'm gonna retie. Man, almost out of the same bush. I have hardly felt any of those bites. It's just a matter of feeling what your jig normally feels like or whatever your bait is normally feels like and knowing that it's heavier when you pick it up. That was two fish out of the same bush right there. Even after I went in there and made all that noise and had that one all tore up in there and had to get him all pitched right back in there. Another chunk. It's a good day. In the heart of a bush too. Got lucky he swam out of that whole thing out to this big tree. Looks like we've got to tie it off so they don't float out into the lake. That was nice of him. Bushes on this entire stretch. Because as these fish come into this, the back of this pocket, back of this creek, this is the deepest water. This is where they should set up first. They should be the key bushes here, and then on the, just the other side of it. And then it turns into just a big old spawning flat on the rest of it. So the bushes that are going to be different are going to be right here. Thing I have kind of noticed so far today, most of the bushes I've caught fish out of have definitely been much fuller with leaves on them. A lot of these bushes I see are, I don't know if they're half dead or just haven't bloomed out yet. They should have been leafed out already, but considering most of them are. But the ones that I've caught the fish on have definitely been full of bloom. She's all fat. She's coming in. Nice fish. Kind of on an outside bush again. That one didn't have quite as many leaves on it, but hey, look at that one. Stud of a fish. Beautiful fish. That never gets old. Here's the other creek channel. The other creek channel, look at that. Man, we could have used one more of those yesterday. We'd been in the money. Wow. Flip, 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 nothing. Back to back flips. 3.5 pounders. Crazy. Goes to show you, you just gotta keep pitching. Keep pitching, keep pitching, keep pitching. The minute you think the bushes that they're gonna be in, you don't get bit. Not that they shouldn't have been in these. That creek comes through there and then comes through here, so we're kinda in between spot of them. That's one thing. Flippin Bushes is just trying to keep a good low pitch too. Not just for the noise factor, but to keep your line out from the rest of the bush. The rest of the limbs and twigs and stuff hanging out there. And that's another reason I don't use braid when flipping wood. In fact, it doesn't have the characteristics of the mono and fluorocarbon, obviously, which have just seem to have a little springier, a little, I don't know what it is, just their makeup allows them to kind of bounce through that stuff and follow the bait down, where once that bait hits the water, it kind of stops moving for the most part. Your line on braid just flops and will wind up just laying in all the branches. You can't like shake it loose or work it down through there for whatever reason. I don't know what it is, what makes it do it, but that's why mono and fluorocarbon, when they go down, when that bait hits, it'll still follow that bait down through the water better than what the braid does. Pretty fish. Got my little craw leg off there. Old magic craw. Magic craw skirt, magic craw Yo Daddy. It's been magic today. guys are not gonna believe this. Let me get this camera out here. This is a fish I've got wedged up in there that I'm gonna go try to get. After he bit my jig, jumped out and around that branch and landed right there. So, put this camera back. And I'm gonna go in and try to get him. Now, if this was tournament day, that fish isn't going to stay on there like that. Like I said before, watch out for snakes. That was the best one of the day right there. Probably a good one to end with. Point bush. She was right down in the heart of it. All fat. Look at that tail bleeding. She's down there getting ready to make more babies. Wow, what a stud of a fish. Right where she was supposed to be. Flipped it right in the heart of that bush. Yeah, nice fish. Could have used her yesterday. Hopefully we taught you a little something today on flipping bushes, just sticking with it. We flipped this whole bay. That was the only fish in this whole bay was on this point bush. That was a, I'm gonna say that was a 5-pound female. She was, she's down on the bottom of that. She was getting ready to lay eggs. Tail was all bloody. Put it right in the middle of it. Got that outcast tackle juice jig. Went right down through just the way it's supposed to. But, hopefully those tips we taught you today with having a, you know, some sort of head design that's a little bulkier, that'll bounce through that stuff, a trailer that's not going to be a lot of appendages on it, something just smooth, easy, it's going to go down through there, whether you're flipping a jig or, you know, flipping plastic. Didn't really flip the tube a whole lot today, but, you know, a tube, something easy to that goes down through that brush easy. It's not like flipping grass. There's definitely its own set of parameters when you're fishing bushes. So I'm hoping that I was able to teach you something today. You enjoyed what we caught. We had a pretty decent peck. We've only been out for a couple hours, so I'm gonna try to catch a couple more before I go in, but I think I'm gonna add the video on that, and hopefully you guys learned something from it. But till next time, tight lines. This is Brian with Fishing Hype Outdoors.